So, as you can imagine, the last few years has shown us a plenty of productivity applications. We've seen the rise of Notion, the rise of Evernote, and many more. And we see applications enter the space and leave faster than you can imagine. Today's video, I'm going to dive into why I think this note-taking application called Mem is of interest in 2022, and why I think it's one of those apps to watch. So let's dive into today's video. So if you're new here and you're interested in this sort of video, I think you'll love the rest of the channel. Keep productive. You can subscribe below if you want to. And if you like this video, hit like as well. So I'm really bullish on Mem. Mem is a note-taking application that has grown a lot of traction in the last year. They received quite a heavy round of funding, but most importantly, it is got a ton of features that I think are quite exciting when it comes to a note-taking application. I want to talk today, starting about the features and elements that interest me and why that they make sort of a different experience compared to the other applications. And then I'm going to talk about the sort of future elements that I believe are pretty fundamental. Primarily, Mem is a note-taking application. It's got a timeline view, so you can create new notes and view the notes you've opened as well. But it's very similar to sort of a basic text editor to some extent, although you can add the regular image files and everything else you'd expect, not databases, but obviously it's not trying to be a Notion replacement. It's also got an inbox, it's got tasks, and it's got groups for collaborating on different documents with other people, and it's also got flows as well. Now, the flows element's probably the element that gets me most excited, because you've got the templates that you can set up and press slash command and bring up templates pretty instantaneously. You've also got scheduled mems, so you can organize mems that pop up and you can start typing away on them. I also like some of the Zapier integrations where you can connect your mail as well, and you can really build up some great workflows as well. And you've even got a daily mem as well for journaling too. So it's got some really nice workflows that you can implement inside of the application. There is a feature inside of Mem that gets me really interested, and it's something called Spotlight. Now, the great thing about Spotlight is you can bring it up on Mac and Windows. They recently added that, where you can basically go ahead and create a new Mem. You can press Tab, for example, and start a Mem, like just note take while you're on top of an application. Or you can search anything that you might have inside of your Mem account. I don't have anything inside this Mem account at the moment, but you can search anything from hashtags to more extensive Mems or notes that you've created. And if you're on any of the pages, for example, you're on Google and you're reading an article, you can clip an article and not just add it as a brand new mem, but you can also add it to an existing mem at the bottom of it. So it really does give you an interesting layer when it comes to being able to capture stuff on the web. So this is actually a feature that from day one, a lot of applications don't have. And that's really interesting, because this is like almost like what it took Evernote like ages to get to, what it took Notion to get to in terms of being able to capture stuff. So it's really exciting to see features like this that people can jump into and really get involved in. Well, who do I think Mem is best for? I think this application is probably suitable for those who want to take bi-directional note-taking, but they don't want that heavy education that applications like Rome and Obsidian will have when they start. So as you can imagine, it allows you to do quite a bit off the bat without having to have that large amount of learning and education about how to use the tool. Mem also does smaller things like connects to your calendar so you can have meeting notes, allows you to collaborate with other people, and more recently allows you to publish your notes whether to the web or whether to other people to be able to view them. One of my favorite features as well is inside of Spotlight, you can actually capture stuff, and anything that's captured can go into inbox so you can process it for later. And tasks also help you to keep on track of what's going on inside of notes, which is something that Evernote's just recently added. To be honest, this application is super early days, and that brings me on to talking about the future of the app. Now, when I actually chatted with the team behind Mem, they were more interested in the long-term elements of Mem and how that's contextually relevant. So Mem wants to be more of this sort of engine for your productivity. So being able to help you plug into other applications in the future, to give you and be able to communicate with those applications, to be able to really fuel whatever you're working on. And that's quite an interesting concept, because that's where I think productivity, personal productivity applications will go in the future. I think they'll become almost like the opportunity providers with connecting to other applications and doing stuff in the background as well. Imagine opening your mem in, say, 5 to 10 years' time, and it's automatically brought in, you know, your plane tickets and communicated with other applications, and maybe even it's brought up your checklist for the trip. It's that sort of like machine learning that I think will be relevant with this application, and that's where I think this app is well placed in terms of the market, is being able to connect with other applications. And I'm really impressed at how in its early stages it's doing in terms of how it's set up, and also in terms of the speed of development as well. I tend to get feelings about applications. I had that feeling with Notion. I remember the first time I tried it in 2017, and I was like, okay, this is something very different to what the productivity space has ever sort of felt. And this is also getting that same feeling in terms of being able to use this application to a lot further. And I think it's going to be a hit with people who are note takers, people who care about their sort of management of their own personal information. And I think it's got a really interesting next couple of months for sure. So I'll probably be covering the more recent mem features that do get launched, but if you want to join the course that we've got, you can check it out in the link in the description. It'll probably be discounted for Black Friday if you're interested. Thank you very much, folks. I hope you enjoyed today's video and why I'm interested in this app mem for 2022. Cheers, folks.